Hallo. Okay, we're online. Let's try to get the pie target done today. 2 weeks ago, we got this working. So, graphics are running on top of everything else. Input was not yet working. Audio was not yet working. So we will try to fix that, and maybe we can even get some kind of Windows support going. Okay, since last time we got some new resources to help us out in our GitHub ticket. Some new hints from Raphael. Robert did a live stream. Don't know who that Window without full screen, problem. Yes, we noticed. Okay. Here we have a library that does input on the Pi, and we will have a close look at that in a moment. And Gepatto is helping out too. He has been working on Pi support for OpenFL, whatever that is. Sounds kind of stupid. Anyway, SDL sounds stupid too, but he got working. A mouse pointer, keyboard support, and touchscreen support. We won't do mouse pointer support because if I would want to do that, I wouldn't want to do it in a platform-specific way. Keyboard support, we will try to do that. Touchscreen, I don't have that. And he's also telling me SDL is using ALSA for audio on the Pi. And that is indeed less work because we have the code for that in the Linux target. Okay. So he used for input UDEV and FDEV. So we have the Wikipedia article, so we know what we are doing. UDEV is some low-level hardware management stuff, and I would guess we won't have that much to do with this. But FDEV, generic input event interface in the Linux kernel. So that's actually the stuff for input that's running below X, which sounds like exactly the right thing to use for us. And this is where we can hopefully see how it all works. Input.c might help us. Some code, some code, some code, more code. Pigou poll events device sounds useful, so let's see where that is defined, maybe. Seems to be one layer above what we want to see. That was input. Let's have a look at state. Ah, okay. Let's have a look at Pigou. PCM host init, we know that, we did that ourselves. Pigo detect device. No. Do we have to look in a different directory maybe? Lib. What's in lib? Oh, not so much. Include. Not very helpful. Where is the actual? Let's go back to init.c. input.c. Init access data. Ta, 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 ta. I think this is the. This is some of the stuff we actually need. Poll events device. Read. That sounds about right. You know, in Unix systems, everything is a file system, is hooked into the file system. Also, input events, I guess. So you do read. And that looks to be just what we need. So we have to find out where info fd is initialized. Let's see. Guess somewhere here. fd, info fd is fd. Open. Okay, let's try to use some of this. Can you all hear me, by the way? Is anybody here? Am I completely alone? Speaking to myself? Okay, back to the Py backend. System CPP. Create window. Okay. Where do I usually put the input code? Let's have a look at the Linux source code. The Linux target, by the way, is the smallest of all of them. So if you want to have a look at how things are usually done, that's the best one to peek into. Lots of code, target display stuff. Of course. Handle messages is one important function. That's where I get the input events, and is some init code for that around here. We'll probably put that in the create window code. Because usually, on desktop targets at least, the window is where you get your input from. So, that's in window, and we will put some Input Code hier. So, what is device? No, that's not the start. Detect device, no. What device? Let's go back. No, that was, yes. Detect device name, and name is def input event 0, event 1, and so on. So we will do this thing too. Info the type. Okay, let's try this first. Or something like this. 64 chars should be enough for everything. Max event index, where does that come from? Okay, at least three people hear what I'm talking. Hi everybody. But max event index, where is it? Where is that defined? Some stuff. Oh, here's some. Let's try this. Let's make this little piece of code compile. As printf. This we won't use like that. Okay, just making it compile for now. Adding some headers. Compile. That we can fix. Oh, pity. Max event index not defined. Let's search max event index Linux. Let's see, max event, not here. No. Nobody knows it. It doesn't exist. How do I? What is that? No. Probe event includes 20 files. We don't want to include 20 files. No, way too complicated. This sounds interesting. An E-Mail. Next event. I don't see it. Ah, here it is. Perf probe event. Doesn't sound like the right thing for us. Complicated. No more results. Ooh. Let's go back to Pigo. Has to be somewhere in here. Include Pigo header. That one does not include anything. State.h, maybe. We got that one. That should be just OpenGL stuff, I think. And we probably already included that. Maybe not, or maybe in the. Let's try. Can only go wrong. No. If this takes any longer, I'll just define it myself. What else could it? Is it? Is it maybe not a Linux thing and it's defined in here somewhere? Might that be the solution? No, don't see it. Can I search this? Max event index. Aha. How many inputs will be checked? Okay. It's just some random number and let's make it look random because it is. Okay. Compiles and yeah, not very exciting yet. Okay. Pigo detect device. Let's look into this. We've seen it before. Pigo detect device. Types events. This opens the device. Fancy formatting. Anyway, that's not important. That's not important. Let's just see whether we can open the device. What was device? Device. Device, I think, was the name, right? Let's use a second tab. The important files seem to be this one, input.c and pgu.c. Yes, name is the device. Name. Printf found a device. Let's see. Compiles. Crashes, but I for three devices. That is sufficient. But how did it crash? Where did it crash? Can I? Call stack doesn't look very exciting. Debugging works, by the way, at least in theory now. I could set breakpoints last time I tried. But this call stack, Anyway, let's use a breakpoint. That's a much nicer call stack. And this one, next line, works. Ah, that's kind of wrong. Let's try this. Does it compile when I? Yes. Oh, breakpoint. Okay. It still runs, and we found three devices. Let's grab more code. Detect device. So, what is this fancy stuff here? Pgu device info t, get device name. Okay. Let's try. What is this macro? Do I need that? Was that percent s, I think, for a string? Maybe. Stupid names. Let's not care about the names. Oh, let's have a look at what that actually is. System call for device specific input, output, whatever. If that's just one system call for all kinds of stuff, probably a request code number. Okay. We need that macro thing after all. Where is it? Two keyboards. Not true, but we don't care. Microsoft Mouse. Actually true. Atlantic Mouse. The mouse can swim. Okay. Works. And the other syscall. Query supported event types. And types is this thing. Okay, let's do it. Seems reasonable. Got the name, we got this. Types, types, types. Types. Okay. Okay. Pigu get bit. Pigu get bit. Not here. Probably somewhere else in here. Pigu get bit. What is it doing? Another system call. EVO CG bit. No, that's not actually Pigu get bit. That's just another Pigu get bit call. Pigu get bit, Pigu get bit. Get bit. No, get bit. That's not true. I saw it. Get bit. Looks like that's somewhere else. More tabs. No. Let's remember this is empty. This is. Okay, that's not very complicated. Do we have an anonymous namespace? Yes, we do. Get bit. Bit. Okay, get bit. Bits, bit. Shift things around. Returns a bit. Okay. What were we trying to do? Something in here, I think. Getbit. Okay, so this thing just peeks into types. And types is an array. Is that right? Getbit, yes. Aha, okay, it's an array of 32-bit integers, and we catch single bits from that array. Okay. Okay, and if that one is set, what is going on in that case? Count events. I think this is figuring out what kind of device that is. And what is this? I don't know. Looks like some joystick stuff. Okay. Okay, and here it sets the type of the device. Okay. And when it pulls the events, this gets device info. So there's probably some loop over that. Or not. Where is poll event device called? Not here. Searching. Aha. Okay. And state.keyboard is what? Button data, device info. What is state? State. What is it? Is it here? Something called state, or was it? Where is our state? Input state. Pigou global state it is. And keyboard. Keyboard is an array of Pigou device infos. And does that make sense? Maybe. Okay, this is not integer addition. that is pointer arithmetic. Okay. In this case, let's find the first keyboard and poll it for events. I think we need basically this code. Key count. Is that set somewhere? Key count, key count. Joystick, mouse, key max. Key count. Okay. Looks complicated. Let's pull it apart. Okay. Okay. If get bit count events we still have this one that should work. Is this defined? We will find out. Get bit key count is not defined. Button mouse, do we need that? Let's try without all of this for now. Is this? Yes. Get bit was not declared. I called it something else, I guess. Get bit. Aha. Get bit. Compile. Events was not declared. Key count was not declared, that's correct. Two warnings. Defined but not used, that's not so bad. Okay. Key count. Zero. Okay. Okay. Joystick button count, gamepad button count, mouse button count. We ignore all of those for now. Let's just get the keyboard working first. Okay. We don't close it, we keep it open. And then I guess we pull it. And if it's a keyboard, we set a bit. Event Code, Event Value, Event Type. Okay, anyway, we have to keep this one around. Let's call it input device. And let's create a small array. Everything counts. Replace random numbers with other random numbers. Okay, and this is input devices. Okay. This initializes all elements in the array. So we can do this if block ourselves at another point in the code. And replace some code. Oh, how did I do that? Okay. Input device, okay. Okay. And now, handle messages. Let's do it. Okay, another loop. And exactly this we need two. Input event, read size, and count. Let's grab all the stuff. And we will just take care of the keyboards for now. So that's C syntax. We don't need it in C++. Event count. Input devices number I. Continue. Continue. resize. A little nicer like that. This one, put event. Okay, let's okay, let's not do the loop for now and just have a look into event code and event value. Printf code might work. Doesn't compile. Doesn't compile. Okay, what? Compiles. Okay, let's see. Oh, lots of values, even without me doing anything. Okay, not very useful. But of course we always print it, even if this is zero. If resize this makes more sense. Okay, I move the mouse and I get values. And I type something on the keyboard and nothing happens. Maybe because that's grabbed by another application. Or do I get everything because I'm using fdev? No keyboard event. What was that? Was that the keyboard? Probably not. No, I think I don't get keyboard events. Pity. Okay. Oh. This one got some keyboard events. Okay, so that's how the loop works. Just gets another one. Let us do that too. And let us indent everything correctly so we don't get confused again. Resize. Read this one. Okay, we won't need this anymore. So let's see. Mouse working. Ah, that. Aha. Relative mouse coordinates, I guess. Interesting. Ah, and now I get keyboard events. That is very nice. Okay. Whatever all of that means, but I'm getting something. Okay. That's nice. We got keyboard events. Okay. Pigo set bit. Keyboard key state. Okay. So let's close this and this and this and this. And open more of this. We wanted to have a look at Pigo device info. That is, I think, in here. Pigo device info. Keyboard. Let's pick it up. Put it in here. And Pigo util. Set bit. Aha. So we need all of it. What license is this anyway? Read me copying. I guess that's okay. In the end, there won't be much left of it anyway, but to get things started, it's much easier to just put some code in and refactor later. Enable bit. I don't usually use inline declarations because that's up to the compiler, and as far as I know, normally they ignore that anyway. Enable bit. Disable bit. Okay, what does it do? It's again an array of values containing bits, and that's probably the index. And that's probably just 1 or 0. What is loo? Ah, that's not loo, that's A one. One, ooh, yes, that's a one. An unsigned one. Yes, it shifts one bit mod 32. Aha, so the bit, this is not just one or zero, but the bit is in here somewhere. Okay. Interesting. Here we are. Get bit. Read input events and wrong. Yeah. This one for keyboard input. Okay. Set bit. Let's see, set bit. Okay, might actually compile, and it does. Okay, now we have some value in our key state. But there's not only key state, there's also keys, and we probably remove the code which initialized this one. Okay. Okay. Oh, event code, event value, bit. This is event.code, this is event.value. Aha. Aha, value is the one which contains just a one or a zero, of course, yeah. And bit is an index, basically. Okay. And do we have any code to assign those indices to actual keyboard keys? Let's run it again. Maybe now we can understand what's going on. Okay, so I pressed the right, arrow key and I moved the mouse. So this time I don't move the mouse. This is one key, six events. Okay, it's pressing and unpressing value 458831. Does that even make any sense? And code 0. Does this make sense? I guess only the 106 is important. Let's press the left key. 105. Yes. Okay, 105, 106. Let's see, do we still have this one? This is the code to send the keyboard events to everything else in the system. So, handle messages. If event.code is 105, if event.value is 1, then we have a key down of key right, no left. I think. And this one doesn't really have a char. And else key up. And let's do basically the same thing. For the other key. Key down, key right, key up, key right. Okay. Compiles. And we can play Tetris. Oh, there's some fancy key repeat stuff going on, which makes Tetris hard to play. But okay, how do we get the key repeat nonsense out of our system? Code 105. Okay, we have to keep track of which key is already set. Okay, let's make something really quick. Anyway, we'll just get things working here in the stream. I will clean it up later and probably will also add support for all the other keys later because that's really boring work and won't help you out very much. Yeah. Wrong key, I guess. Here. There's a microphone between me and the keyboard. Oh. is false. Okay, maybe that helps. Maybe not. Where is that? Oh, how that did. Ah, middle mouse button, I guess. Right is still problematic, but left also. This didn't help at all. And why not? Ah, don't move the mouse. Ah, repeat gives value 2. That's easy. That's actually pretty nice, right? If and else if event.value is 0. And this way it should just ignore repeat events. Yes, perfect Tetris. Okay, let's just add the key to go down. It's 108. And 57 is base. Eight down, and what was it? 58? What's the key anyway for rotating the block in this game? Ah, up. Okay, we won't need this anymore. Okay, 5, 6, 8, we will see. Whoosh, and up is 103. All the keys you will ever need, unless you want to implement a high score list. Working. Perfect. Okay, that's keyboard input. Mouse input will be kind of hard. It's looks kind of hard because we only get relative mouse coordinates from fdev, right? Right. Can we somehow get the initial mouse position? Okay. Let's first implement audio support, I think. More exciting, less tedious. This works. Looks kind of okay. Needs a big cleanup. This code later. Okay. Check it in. Just one file. Okay. Very basic keyboard support. Okay. So let's try to implement audio support. And let's try to just use this one from the Linux backend, which uses ALSA, which is supposed to work on Pi 2. Let's see. Override. You can be right, you can be wrong, and you can be override. Hey, get me the new file. Yes. We might need to execute this to get the headers and lib files for ALSA. But let's just try. Target is up to date. Okay. Stupid compiler thing. Make file, whatever. Yeah. Let's try this. Where's my copy command? Oh, it's in the sub menu. Okay. Yes, please. I think it's working. Let's wait. Okay, let's try to compile again. Undefined reference, that's not that bad. Tools, core make, exporter code blocks. R sound. Okay, let's put it in here for now. Build options. Everything. Oh, no. R sound. Okay, it compiled and linked. Do I have to do anything special here? No. Would run on its own thread, so we don't really have to do anything more. Let's see. Broken pipe, playback callback failed. What does it mean? Okay, first thing to protect you, I'll use my speakers first, because when you do audio programming and just get things working, you end up with ugly noises normally. Okay, let's try again. Oh! It actually worked fine for a few seconds. Until I moved the mouse, I think. What happened there? No, I don't touch anything. Oh, it's playback callback failed. Broken pipe. It works for 1 or 2 seconds. And then it stops. Okay. Broken pipe. Is that message in here? Playback callback failed. That was one of the messages, right? Yeah, playback callback failed. Playback callback. Playback callback. Isn't that the function which I define? Playback callback, playback callback. No, it's this thing. Aha, right, failed. Why does it fail? Let's try a little hack first. Oh, this. Now it's not playing any sound at all. Oh, playback, what was right at the top? Playback callback failed. Let's try again. Playback callback. Oh, is zero wrong? PCM right I. Okay, what should we do when this one returns a negative value? We panic and run out of the room. How to use it? Before we start reading more stuff, let's just. Oh, we won't need that anymore. We'll need this. Ah, let's just fix this, right? Because that's easy. There, fixed it. Okay. Our buffer has some random size, of course. Let's play with that. Okay, divided by 2 because it's 2-channel sound. It's our magic number anywhere else still. Find next. Oh. No, that's actually okay. Don't think we have to change that. Okay, we're back at the top. Let's see if it still works like it worked before. Yes, plays for about 1 second. More. Sample, what does that do? Seem to run shorter. Seem to run a little longer, but that's not a proper solution. Does that actually change anything, changing the size of that buffer? For example, no, I don't think so. Let's do this. Oh, took even longer, but still failed. And if it failed once, it doesn't go back. So what was this guy's problem? Okay. PCM, right. No, no, no. Yes. Ah, interleaved transfers, non-interleaved transfers. Okay, good to know. Okay, there are some actual return values. Ah, Sound STR Error. Anyway, I think this really makes sense. And right failed. So we should have more. Broken pipe. Broken pipe. I guess that's E-pipe. Underrun occurred. Which means we don't put the sound in fast enough. Let's check if error 2 is EBAT. Is that? No, E-pipe. We want to check for E-pipe. No, it's not E-pipe. It's not that one either. Of course, it's always the last one. And it keeps on. Ah, now. The error code is something else. Right, failed. Let's see what value that actually is. Still playing. Still playing. Still playing. Sound effects working too. So that seems to be completely random. I don't like random errors. Ah, there it is. -32. Now let's see. E pipe is defined. And when we go to the declaration, wasn't it 32? I'm going mad, I guess. Let's see again. Minus 32. Ah, I have to negate it, I guess. Interesting. Okay. So it's ePipe after all, and ePipe is an underrun occurred. That's something at least. Okay. What do we do about that? Underrun. Is an underrun which means the sound is played back faster than we provide it. How does that happen? Are we maybe just too slow? Let's keep it going for a minute or something. Now it stopped again. So even in release mode it happens. But why is that? Playback callback. What was that fancy code here? Okay, still happening. Frames to deliver. This is frames to deliver. So doesn't look like it's very fast code, but it should still work. Audio callback, n frames times 2. That's okay. Hmm. Maybe it really doesn't like us calling it again and again in this loop, which isn't very clever anyway. No, I think that's actually NI0. No, it already tries to call that only when buff is full. That's completely okay. Yes, that's nice actually. Let's make this really small. Let's make this really huge. No, it's all the same. Don't think this matters at all. Let's see, can we handle that somehow? E pipe. How to gracefully recover from ePipe errors? Underruns can happen at any time. Let's try to recover. Okay, let's use proper syntax. Oh, it needs. Okay, not that easy. Another tab. Recover. Recover the stream state from an error or suspend. Okay, we have sound PCMT. What is playback and okay. Playback handle. silent. Do I have to set a minus? Maybe. Let's just try. Oh, didn't work. Let's try again like this. Didn't work either. Well, that's kind of okay. Does recover have a return value? Yes, it does. And it's of type int. Int recovered. Okay. Recovered 0, that looks good actually, but the sound still stops. Let's try again if whether this returns something else. No, it always recovers. But what happens afterwards? Okay, so callback. Debugging windows, watches, recovered 0. Let's not break. Nothing is happening. It's still working. Doesn't even print anything. That is stupid. Still nothing. Still working for some reason. Again. What was that? What? Now it stopped the program. What did that? Breakpoint? Breakpoint. It recovered. That's it. Try again. Why? It recovered two times. It recovered again. It's still working. And I can hardly hear it. I mean, the error. Recovered again. Okay. That's not perfect, but I think it's okay for today. So, what did we do? We don't break here. Do not break, so we can recover from errors. Okay. And okay. Okay, let's check it in. Sound done for today, but should have a closer look at it after the stream. Maybe I can avoid the underruns altogether. Would be better. Git status. It changed something in Quamac, right? Deezer is asking why the game is transparent. That is because you can't actually put hardware accelerated OpenGL graphics in a window on the Pi. You can just put stuff on top. And so I made it partly transparent so I can still see what's going on. Status. Yes. I edit alsa lib to py export. Okay. Okay, some keyboard controls are in, some audio is in. And maybe I can let you hear the audio for a moment. Let's try doing high-tech stuff here. Switch this one to HDMI. Then switch the sound on in the recording. And then start. And maybe you can hear it now. Can you hear it? I can't hear it, but maybe you can. Okay, back to analog. Okay. We have basic input, we have basic sound. Now we try to run it in a window. This should be the code for not using the complete screen. Let's see if that works. System CPP. Display manager. Get display size. Destination rect. Source rect. And what is this doing? Source rect. Destination rect. Not sure why they are multiplying the source rect. Yeah, I don't know either. So something else in destination rect just and source rect. Okay. Let's see. Yeah, it's working. And I can probably move it around a little. No, not here. Yeah. Yes, working. Okay. And if I take something else here, what's happening then? Then it's broken. Okay. Okay. So don't change this one ever. Okay. Use the parameters. Okay, but it's resizing the image, which I don't want. But it's kind of useful. Window mode. Okay. Let's use this. If window mode It's full screen. Then we make it full screen. Else we don't. Wrong key. Okay. So can we maybe make it not then this? No. Oh, okay, it's an enum class. And like this. Or maybe like this. Yippee. Okay. Okay, at some point we should change this. Maybe now. No, I can't find the button to close it. Let's keep it like this for now. Makes it easier for me. Transform native window width. Native window width. What is it? Ah, and that's what Gepato is talking about in the chat. Okay, native window width, native window, and what is happening with native window? It's here. Okay. Let's try to make that smaller. Let's make this smaller too. Ah, so this is working. But what is my Tetris doing at the top right of this thing? Ah, maybe this. No. Okay, Native Window deklariert hier. Aha. Okay, really only width and height and whatever that is. Aha, more hints from Gepato. He keeps this one with this one. What does that do? Ah, we had this before. Doesn't look right, but looks fancy. Okay, back. Looks perfectly fine, but it moves my stuff around. And I set those back to zero. Still moves it. Let's see here. That's that. That's that. This is what got us lots of weird errors in our image. Oh, why does it happen? It's all just width and height now. And yet it does something strange to it. That's our input code. Ah, little mouse button. Don't know. Let's read some documentation. Display manager X element add. Also done for now. What was that? Okay. Scrum VM added support for that. Or did they? Yes, it's merged. Destination React, Source React. Oh, and what is Bitmap React? Source React, Source Width, Source Height. Destination, okay. Remember, we have to transfer the whole bitmap. Even if he would have interest in a part of it. What does that mean? We call this to yes, update start, update submit sync, and we press the middle mouse button again, I guess. Does it even still compile? Yes. That's not very much. Is there any actual documentation about this somewhere? At least full screen works fine. I do something like this. No. I do something like this. No. Why doesn't this change anything? I already tried this variation. Why doesn't that make any difference? When I go back to this, that was when we had when everything was wrong. Yes. Well, of course, this is not right. Did we make that before? That's what we had before. And this should scale it, I think. Yes. What else can we do out of ideas? Alpha from source, alpha fixed all pixels. We can at least do make full screen perfect. Okay, but what about this other stuff? EGL create window surface. Is native window used for anything else? Yes. No. Just for GL create window surface. And it The scaling behavior makes sense. But this translation does not. Really could need some actual documentation about this. Just guessing games here. More guessing, let's try to not use the shift. And it's all the same. Why is that? Makes no sense. Oh, at least that looks different. Kind of makes sense because now source rect is two times the native window. And I do this. No difference. Why? Why doesn't it care about this here? Oh, that didn't work. Well, at least something. Where does that translation come from? Let's try something. Let's add some color. Ugly color and it's everywhere. Oh, why is this open? And this didn't change anything either. No. Okay, if nobody has any further ideas, I think I close this for today, because I'm just guessing and that's boring, not interesting to watch in a video. And I just have no idea currently where that translation comes from. No idea at all. Also, no idea why so many parameters don't actually change anything. This one at least works. Yes, it does. The scalar I apply at the end. What scalar? Dieser is writing I apply a scalar at the end. But I don't know what he means. No idea. Did he mean scalar and not scalar, what he wrote? Where is width and height? Screen with set. Do I set that somewhere? I should. Where is it? I should set it before this happens. Here, yes, that's okay. That's okay. Quick hack. Sorry, it was my fault. Thanks, Deezer. Width is height. No. Okay. Grab this one. Okay. Working. All working. Okay, there's just one more thing to do, and that is do the same thing that Minecraft does, because Minecraft runs in a window, but this window is a hack. And we could do the very same thing. When in window mode, open an X window and then put our game on top. So let's go back into our Linux backend. Backends, Linux, source core. System. How do we open a window? Oh, that became more complicated because it now supports multiple windows. X open tralala. GLX, we don't even need that. X create window, that's nice. Let's try namespace, namespace, namespace. Open X window. This one. What is DP epsilon? It is a display pointer. Okay. Display pointer. X open display, X open display. GL stuff we don't need because we don't actually render anything into that. Don't think we need this either. X create window. X set standard properties. Oh, that sounds cool too. Okay, X create window, root window, is that some, what is that? What is this? I don't know, what is this? What is this? And what's this? Title is this. SWA actually does some stuff, so we need that after all. Oops. Have to declare it somewhere. X visual info. That's okay, that's okay, that's not okay. We have to initialize that somehow. How does that happen? GLX choose visual. I don't want that. Do I really need that? Root window screen, can I get that? I don't want most of that. Max Visual Info. Let's search for that. Okay, dann X get visual info. We have choose visual. Looks complicated. Can't we have something easy? Open X window. X windows tutorial. Oh, YouTube video, no. Short xlib tutorials, that sounds okay, but okay, let's get that. The window. Yes, downloads, xlib, proc 1. That is nice. That is what I want. Was just map window to. I just grab this code. Please use freely. Acknowledge. I acknowledge that is the contribution by Tronche. Okay, less code. We don't need an assert. What is this? This, this, this. Let's see. So much code. Open X window. Oh, okay. Let's take this one. Oh, do we even need those one? Oh, where might that be hidden? X11 not found. Let's do this. Oh, pity. What can it be? Where did he install it? Aha. Okay. Much better. Very funny. Another one. Ah, okay, that's okay. Those we don't need, but this one. Okay, and do we need this? No, we don't. Undefined reference. That is easy to fix. Tools, core make. Code blocks exporter. X11. And in here. X11. Build. Links. Runs. Ah, here, it's the window. that's this corner was not cleared. Unnamed window. Very nice. So now we just have to resize it. Like this. And we have our pseudo window mode. Oh, yes. Oh, Okay. But maybe we should let the computer do that. Oh, X window. Okay. Let's do it. Ja. Not quite. Ah, but the size is exactly right. Position, not so much. And why not? It was. Seems to be at the bottom left. Okay, guess that function works, doesn't work the same way I guessed. Open X window, X create window. X, Epsilon, Width, Height. Border Width, Depth. Oh, there are simple windows. What's the difference? What was this? It's okay. Third parameter, x. 1, 2, 3. Looks all right. I still need this. Maybe. Breakpoint. Both 100. That's okay. Not working. Why not? Oh, it's all the same. Guess I have to call some other function. X create window, X set window attributes. What does X map window do? No idea. Let's try to work without it. Without this. No window. So looks like map window kind of makes it visible. And we also have to flush. Okay. Only Flush. We need all of it. Okay, all the nodes back. Does that look like actually? Ah, it's just an ID. Okay. Configure window. No ad blocker installed. Sorry. Hey, X move window. That's nice. I like it. But does it work? Display. Okay. No, it does not. Why not? Maybe flush it. Aha. That is almost correct. Now, can we get the size of the top border thing somehow? Resize window, move resize window, and the border width. Set window border. And how about get window border? X11. Get window border. Get X11 window caption height. That sounds good. X window attributes. The title is not part of that window. Managed by the window part. It's part of what is called decoration. And how do I get that? The answer? Very funny. Okay. So, do that after this. What is A? An atom. Of course it is. Atom. 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 This. Ooh. Complicated. So D with the display. No. Yes. D. W is a window. Yes, the atom. T F N B E. T is another atom. Why that? What is F? An integer. And what is it good for? Don't know. N and B. And E is an event, right? Right. And data. D. D, D, D. That's the display. Whoop. Oh, and that's the display too. Extents. Yeah, I guess that's a long pointer. Guess so. And that compiles. And now let's add extents of one. Let's see. Now it's all broken. Oh, I guess it's in the loop, huh? Is it? Oh. No, isn't. And extends is, can I somehow extends? Oh, one, that's not very much. That's at least a little bit. I guess this doesn't exist. But oh, there it is again. And where's my window? My window is gone. And now it's not working again. Minus. Yes, that's nice. And this was one, I think. Okay, I hope nobody ever uses a different window manager or anything like that. And now I would like to get some window events back for when I move the window around. For starters, maybe an event for when I close the window. Do we have that in here? And the messages expanding key press, key release, press. Oh, configure notify, interesting. Let's do this. Input devices and X events. No. Yes. Okay. Oh, okay. Let's silence the input events. Nothing. Nothing is happening. Still nothing. Oh, what's that? I closed the window. Aha, and that crashes. Ah, crashes here, I guess, when the window is gone. But no events. Why not? X11 resize event, or even just move event. No, not mouse movement. Move window event. Configure notify. Size, position, border. Configure notify. There's something I'm not doing right. Do I have to activate the event somehow? Something like that, maybe? Aha, set the structure notify mask bit in the event mask attribute of the window. Of the window. Of the window sounds good to me. Create window. Which one is it? Exchange window. Configure window. Map window. Create window. Value mask attributes. Event mask attribute. It means I have to create this and let's look for this and this. Aha. Okay. 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 Not okay. Not working. Do I have those as well in here? Yes. Aha, that's that thing from earlier today. Event mask. Structure notify mask. Aha. The null in here was misleading. Aha, aha. Okay. We are getting some events. And what else do we have? Event.xconfigure. .x, excellent. Okay. Then we just need to do some display manager stuff when the window is moved around. Probably update. Update. Submit sync. Is there also maybe display manager X element change update? Something like this? Let's see. Done with this. Done with this. Done with this. Maybe not. With this. Done with this. This. Done, 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 done. Element, change attributes. Oh, that looks nice. Set opacity does not work here. Oh, who cares? Date element. That is nice. If it works, then it's nice. Okay. Change attributes. We need an update handle and an element handle. I know how to get an update handle, I think. Update start. And this man update, where is it? There. This man x update handle. Disp man x update handle t. Update. Start. What's that parameter? Ah, priority. Okay. But the element, we probably have to remember the element. Displayman element. Display manager element. Like this. Okay. Update. Disp. Man element. Change flags, layer, opacity. That is, I think, just the same stuff we used here. There's an update submit sync. I guess we will have to do that too. Like this. Change flex, layer opacity. Change flex. Change flex. Element add. There's no change flex. That's layer. This one has alpha, this one has opacity. Okay. Destination rect, source rect, mask, displayman x resource handle t. Oh, that is. Don't like that. Transform t. Okay. this kind of thing. This and this and this. Okay. So we got those. We try to set those to 0, which might or might not work. Opacity. Let's try this one. Layer. What is the layer? Zero. Okay. Zero. But what are the change flags? I don't know. Let's try this. Oh. Okay. Okay. This man X transform T. This man update was not up. Just update here. Compiled. Look at it. Windows support. Okay, and it even ends when I close the window because it crashes, but we don't tell. So, and now, we don't need this any longer. Haha. All working. Input sound fake window mode. Can't resize yet, but I don't care. Because I think this was all the exciting stuff. And all the cleanup I can do outside of the stream. And if you like to, you can then have a look at the commits later. But all the basic stuff is in there. So I'll commit this. I think we... Yes, had another change to core make. For the X11 lib. And this one. And that's it for today. Next stream will maybe be Lubos had the idea to do a backend for mono game. So we might do that in the next stream, so we can see how we can build a backend purely in car with no core involvement, purely in hex. And until then, I'll clean up the Pi backend outside of the stream, add mouse support probably, some small stuff. But for now, I close it down. Okay, thanks and bye.